When you drop, you have principality powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. This is how it works, ranking in order. The lower ones, and then they move up to the top ones. Then you drop down to another dimension, prophetess. You go from the sovereign to the angelic. Then you got another dimension, which is the intergalactic. The intergalactic realm is where the sun and moon rule, because they rule in ranking in order. The sun outranks the moon. So even intergalactically, there is order. There are stars that submit to the suns and the moon. Every galaxy has their own sun and moon, and they are the greater and the lesser light. Then you drop down further, and you got the kingdom. There's another kingdom, which is called the animal kingdom. Now, in the animal kingdom works in ranking and order. You have the water kingdom, you have the earth kingdom, and then you have the sky kingdom, the kingdom which is the atmosphere. The eagle is the king of the sky. It is the highest ranking bird. That's why God said, you shall mount up as wings as an eagle. That's a prophetic word. Then you have the lion, which is the highest ranking animal in the earth realm. That's why Jesus is the lion of the tribe of Judah. Then you drop down to the highest ranking in the water world, which happens to be the whale. So everything in every kingdom works by rank and order. Then you go to the planet kingdom. You go to the planet kingdom. After you go to the planet kingdom, then you go to the atomic kingdom. That's where you have fuel. That's where you have jewels. That's where you have oil, petroleum. That's that kingdom. And everything, like the highest gem is the diamond. And so that works in rank and in order as well. Then you drop down to the subatomic kingdom. This is where you get viruses and prions and gravitons and cellular things. They work in rank and in order too. We know about prions because they're mad cow disease. It's a prion. Are you with me? It's single cell. Are you with me? So these are single cell. They all work in rank and in order. But there is another kingdom, and that's the kingdom of man. Now, when you get to the kingdom of man, God says to man in this kingdom, I give you authority over every kingdom except my sovereign kingdom. That means, technically speaking, the church has authority over the animal kingdom, the church has authority over the plant kingdom, the church has authority over the atomic kingdom, the church has authority over the subatomic kingdom. I can prove it scripturally. Number one, intergalactic kingdom. This is where Joshua, in his mantle, he was fighting a battle and it looked like he was losing, and he stood up and he said, son, stand still. What was he doing? He was affecting his authority over the intergalactic kingdom. Not only did the sun stand still, but if the sun only stood still, but Mars and Jupiter kept on moving, it would have caused an atomic explosion. So when he said sun, he poured order to every other galaxy. That means the moon stood still, the sun stood still, Mars stood still, Jupiter stood still, Saturn stood still. And they didn't move until Joshua said to move. Let me prove it again. Here is Elijah. He's got authority over the animal kingdom. He's got authority over nature. He goes out and they begin to say, you don't have any prophetic authority. Nobody is covering you. You're a bald head. He said, all right, I'll prove to you the mantle that I have over you. Bear, come out of the what? Animal kingdom. And a bear came out and it devoured the man. Then he said, listen, I need to get the axe, but I'm not gonna get my hair wet. So he said, water, change your molecular structure. And the axe that was heavier than the water became heavier than the axe, and the axe floated up. He had authority over nation. Not only that, but you see, Jesus said, I don't feel like rowing. So the waters congealed and he walked on water. He had authority over that. We see even Moses with his mantle. It's a prophetic mantle. Moses said, there's got to be a way out. God said, there is a way out. Activate your apostolic anointing. Use your stick. So when he stretched forth his stick, there was a prophetic channel that opened up. And what God gave as deliverance to the children of God became the judgment of the enemy. There are dimensions in the prophetic. There are portals, prophetic portals. There are prophetic doors. There are prophetic windows. There are prophetic paths.